Yo guys, what's going on? For today's video, we are going to be reviewing the Season 8 Grand Finals, Energy versus Vitality, where Energy was able to catch the World Championship dub. Turbo, the GOAT, catching his fourth. Justin, one of the best of all time, best mechanically all time, grabbing his first, as well as Garrett. Everyone knows the story about Garrett grabbing his first against the absolute European GOATs at the time with Vitality. But yeah, we're going to review the Game 6 and Game 7. Spoiler, Energy does win this series. But we're just going to see what made Energy so good. But if you guys are enjoying this type of content, how a pro thinks of things, teaching you guys, maybe teaching you guys how to rank up, please make sure to leave a like and subscribe. We're trying to grow. I'd really appreciate it. And sorry for the lack of uploads recently. I've just been kind of demotivated because of competitive coming back. But now we're on like a long break, so it's just kind of weird. But I'll try and get back into it. But your support means a lot. But let's get into this. So who do we start with? Let's start with the GOAT. Turbo Pulse of Cam. Okay, a little back right action to control possession. Turbo with a touch off the wall to himself. Doesn't really do exactly what he's trying to do, and because of it, they lose possession, so not the greatest. Scrub with an attempted air dribble. And one thing Turbo does really well now, as well as he did on NRG, well, as I was going to say, is a lot of times I'll tell you guys to rotate back post just because I think it's efficient and it's just the easiest. But I believe Garrett and Justin's rotations are so kind of just go back towards net style that Turbo developed the style of cutting every pass or cutting a lot of midfield options. So that's why you see him rotating straight back, even with like no boost, just because he's trying to like cut off anyone that Vitality could follow. So he does that. Unfortunately, kind of just hits them. He just has to get the clear out. No boost. Kadop with a good little touch. Let's see what Kadop saw. So Kadop, scrub places left. Perfect touch. Scrub, not the greatest shot, but he just got it enough. So that was well done. But yeah, Energy just kind of lack a boost and just giving away possession on defense. And then Vitality did well to capitalize. Turbo, good challenge off kickoff. Justin, another good challenge. But no one's really there to follow because of it. Scrub's able to push downfield. Okay. Good demo by Garrett. Removes the offensive threat, so now it's just Fairy Peak. Oh my god, that should have been a goal. Alright, we're going to go to Garrett then. So Garrett does a good job challenging. Unfortunately, couldn't get past Fairy, but gets a good demo. So see, the offensive threat is over. Now, you're just telling your teammates, alright, clear it. Because if we get this downfield, we have a fat counterattack. So Justin gets the clear. Oh, Garrett has no boost. Probably still should be a goal. He probably thought someone was back. But maybe a little bit of the Game 7 finals nerves, or Game 6, so it happens. But that whole sequence of events, that showed how important demos are. Because it just it turned literally a potential Vitality goal in 2 seconds to an Energy, basically, goal, or what could have been. So, Energy, I see Scrub being physical, kind of bumping Justin. Just a lot of midfield challenges going on right now, and because of it, just keeps flipping possession between Energy and Vitality, but so far Vitality's definitely held more of the pressure. Again, another challenge. Justin, spectacular read. Unfortunately, Turbo does not boost to get there. Tries to dime it out mid. Oh, and it's been counterattacked. So we're just going to watch this from Justin's point of view. So Justin grabs the back boost. Gets up so fast. Big read. Turbo zero boost. And Justin's just, instead of going for that mid boost, what Justin should be doing is just like kind of saving his boost and just grabbing these pads around midfield, because I've been doing this lately. I've been playing for big boosts instead of small boosts, like the little pads. Keep this in mind. When you play for big boosts, you're going to get out of rotation and spots you shouldn't be. So because Justin does that, and then Kadop just reads Turbo's pass, their teammates, you know, he's in his head. But yeah, that happens. So again, Justin with a really good clear, but then he kind of just, I think, let his guard down and autopiloted for big boost. He also didn't expect like that fast of a clear. Again, good challenge by Justin on midfield. Energy doesn't want Vitality getting free shots. Good little boost deal. There you go. Good. He keeps it close. Not the greatest touch though. Okay, good little 1-2 clear out. So down 2-0, 3 minutes left, game 6. Can Energy pull this back? So Justin with a good keep of possession. He gets boost. Turbo kind of just gives it right back. I believe Turbo had no boost, but in that scenario, most of the time you want to keep possession and maybe go for an air dribble, try and draw some defenders out. You never want to give the ball away for free, right? If you have possession of the ball, never just try and give it to the other team. Don't hand it to them. A lot of times, if you just lose possession, it ain't gonna result in something good. That's why you see the meta. There's a lot of air dribbles, just regular dribbles, 1v1 players. It's just because it's about keeping possession right now. So just keep that in mind. Okay, K-Dop not the greatest clear. Justin with an interesting recovery. He tried to play that to himself, but I think nerves are definitely a thing right now because normally you don't see Justin doing these kind of things. Oh, wait, open? K-Dop on goal? Oh my god. So this has been almost like 3 goals Energy actually should have scored just based off of little midfield challenges and counterattacks. Just like kind of someone lurking upfield after these challenges. Oh, not the greatest touch. Okay, so let's go back. I believe Justin, again, was trying to set himself up, but just, like, probably his nerves, because Justin, a lot of times, will do something crazy with this ball. But instead, he kind of dimes it out to them. Scrub gets a pass off to a lurking fairy peak, sorry. And, again, like we were saying, Energy wants to do these midfield challenges and not let Vitality get these free shots, right? But instead, since Turbo's late and he does get bean, it leaves Garrett in basically a 1v3. Because look, Justin and Turbo are still floating. So Garrett's got to get a really good read. I think he might probably rush it a little bit, maybe nerves. Not the greatest read, and that's why. But yeah, so far, Energy has just been... they've been really focusing on midfield challenges. But a lot of just like kind of nervous mistakes. But their game plan is really solid. It's been working just a little... couple of mishaps here and there. Just mistakes, and that's what happens at this level. So Justin just gets the perfect beat. Again, Energy's been doing super good job. And this is how you guys should always practice. Try and figure out how to keep possession on kickoffs. I don't think you guys realize how important that is. Like, possession just off kickoff, if your team has boost, it's literally basically a counterattack just off a kickoff. It's not like a stalemate. So yeah, Energy's been doing a really good job of that. Turbo sees no one's backboard, gets a good first touch, follows it up. Clean. Good little double tap skis from the man himself. So again, let's see if Energy keeps possession off kickoff. Yep, he tries to get it back right to Justin. Boom. And Justin's gonna try and do something crazy. Almost. But now, again, really good challenge by Turbo. See, that time since he didn't get beat, look at the difference. Now it's back on Vitality's net. Scrubs force an awkward save. That's how crazy, like, a missed challenge compared to a successful one. Like, a successful one, in a second, it's on the other team's net. If it's unsuccessful, in a second, it's on your net. That's how important, like, all these little details are in Rocket League. Turbo, good job keeping the ball in. Garrett with a little bit of aggressive positioning. Probably didn't predict K-Dop to get that good of a clear. Again, Energy's probably being a tad bit more physical right now than Vitality. Scrub with a bad whiff. Garrett trying to dime this off mid. Okay, a little bit of whiffs and nerves coming out, I think. Just Turbo to have enough boost. Ooh, okay. Let's go to Garrett's. So Garrett, we saw, tries to pop this ball out. You know what I'm saying? Boost luckily spawns at him. I don't know if that was a replay glitch or something. But Fairy has to beat Justin, right? And like I was saying, so Fairy does his job. He beats Justin, but it's not the greatest beat because it does come out mid. And since Justin just landed there, Scrub is now in the place where he has to avoid this physical play from Justin, whether it's a demo or a bump. So because of it, he's a little bit out of position, probably where he'd like. As well, he just went a little bit too aggressive. And Garrett sees that, right? He realized that. So all he needs to do is just basically try and get a shot on target. And he gets it in the left corner. Boom. Perfect. And one goal game, 45 seconds. Anything can happen, especially in a grand finals. Nerves. Crazy stuff has happened. You guys have seen it. Garrett again, securing boost. Should be a boom upfield. See, here's the difference. When we saw Energy, this might be an NA style because it's just faster and like more aggressive. But I've been saying it. Energy's been trying to get those midfield challenges. But Vitality, like, basically everyone in the lobby predicts where this ball's going. It's going upfield to one of the teammates. But no one on Vitality is really want a challenge, right? So Justin kind of has a free hit, but he doesn't really get to do much with it. But it's just crazy the difference. And Vitality's playing that more, you know, defensive style. Like, let the ball come to us, and then we'll counterattack you and wait for your mistakes. Where Energy's trying to force the aggression until they either make a really good play or a mistake from Vitality pops up. But that also does lead them to more mistakes, you know? And we've seen it with a couple misreads, poor rotations. So it's kind of the NA versus EU right now. Garrett, boom, all three in net. Again, no one challenging. That's really tough to score. He's kind of getting a perfect shot, and it's hard to do. Justin, really good beats. Oh, my God. So you remember I was saying Justin nerves? Like, this is the Justin that everyone knows. Gets the perfect pop to himself, still has boost. First touch, immaculate. Oh, that would have been crazy. That would have been one of the craziest moments in Rocket League history. I think I remember watching this live, but beautiful. Ah, so close. But yeah, Vitality kind of, I don't think, really outplayed them. They just capitalized on Energy's mistakes more. While Energy, I think, just got a little bit too nervous maybe at some times. Vitality was able to capitalize. But let's go into Game 7. Okay, Game 7, we're going to start on Justin. So Game 7, right? One game for Worlds. Nerves at all-time high for probably both teams. Again, Justin starting off with a midfield challenge. Going upfield to lurk for a pass. But there is Fairy Peak. He's already challenged midfield. Not something we've seen Vitality do. Justin, pure speed, tries to get a dime off to Garrett. This is actually kind of interesting because I'm not going to lie, I've never really seen Energy. Maybe it was with Turbo, I'm just forgetting because a little bit ago. Oh my god, that ball was just sinking. But Energy's been passing a lot, and Energy doesn't really pass that much. From just experience against them, maybe it was with Turbo. But Energy's been like lurking in midfield, kind of just mixing it up between going for solo plays as well as just getting pressure and passing, which is like something you rarely see. Justin with a crazy confidence turn right here. So right here, he's last man, right? Turbo jumped, but as well as there's Vitality, two players in the corner. If Justin gets beat here, it's probably an open net because Garrett's still downfield. Yeah, Garrett's still all the way downfield. So Justin with the confidence to turn right here. Because look how close. Imagine Fairy Peak's a little bit closer. Boom, that's a goal. And you never want to give up a goal early in game 5. It's always just like put so much pressure on you. Garrett probably would have controlled and air dribbled that in today's game. I'm not going to lie. Maybe would have boomed it. But I think right here, game 7, you'll notice a lot of pros just play boom ball. Exactly what's going on. Because you don't want to be that dude or the team that just, like, you think you're cheeky, you're going to go for an air dribble, boom, dunked in your net. It's just, like, more play it safe. I'm going to force you to make a good play and score on me instead of, okay, I'm going to take this risk in front of my own net. Sorry about the invite. Recording a YouTube video, Aqua, come on. Justin going all the way back for boost again. A little bit of boom ball. Ooh! That's what feels bad. Oh my god, if that was a goal, he would have been heartbroken. But Turbo, icing up on defense. Good communication, though. So far, I've noticed Energy's both teams' communication is really on point, which is what you like to see. Their rotations have been really clean, as well as, like, just challenges. No one's really too many double commits. Dude, there's no way I say that, and then that happens. Oh, like, what is my timing? What the Anyway, so as I was saying, no double commits at all. Boom. Justin with see, right here, this is communication, right? So Justin says he has full boost. I can't. Turbo's like, all right, I'm going to get this. Now, Garrett could easily turn mid here. But Justin's like, I'm going to go mid. Garrett, you stay back. Or Garrett's like, you go mid, I stay back. Either way. But so now they have the entire field use an opportunity. So Turbo can pass it or he can beat Fairy Peak, and then there will only be one defender left. So that was a really good dribble because it's been boom ball, right? So really good way to throw the team off is just to kind of slow down the pace, mix it up. So right here, it could throw them out of positions where one isn't close enough to the other in case a person flicks, then they're not in the range to follow that flick on that challenge, right? So Turbo, that's what he does. He's going for an air dribble. Justin if he knew that immediately, probably wouldn't would have went to go bump. Maybe not. But I like the change of pace from Turbo. Again, maybe going back to boom ball. Turbo again, trying to keep it close. Doesn't really work. Justin with a good double touch. Unfortunately, Garrett really can't commit because he's third man. Maybe in a game one, you'll see him commit for that. Or a game two. But game seven, you're not going to see players committing for that. That's honestly tilting for Justin. Okay, let's go to... We can... Oh, sorry about the cameras. Let's go to Garrett. I just... The energy decals. Garrett playing it safe. Literally just camping the net, basically. Justin in a 1v1. Goes for the bump. Boom. You'd be tilted if you're Scrub. Let's just go back to Justin's point of view. Oh, Scrub has no boost. That's why he can't really do anything. So he gets the touch. Boom. Gets the demo. Ice. Goal for energy. They're up 1-0. Oh. Back to Garrett. Boom. Garrett again, camping the net. Garrett's been playing very defensive. I'd probably call him the third man from these two games. Even though that doesn't really mean much, but I think he's just... He really doesn't want to push up and just give him a free goal if he doesn't have to. Ooh, Scrub with a crucial backflip. Unlucky. Energy with the good passing plays. Good attempts. But again, like I was saying, that's very risky because Vitality is no one challenging, right, for against Energy in these midfield plays compared to Energy, where Energy loves the challenge. So as long as Garrett puts a good shot on, it forces out a good save, which just allows Energy to keep the ball like they're doing right now and just re-counterattack. Garrett's probably going to go all the way back, just probably sit in net. Not sit in net, but like play more defensive, you know what I'm saying. Justin with a good first touch. Ah, not the greatest first touch. Couldn't follow it, unfortunately. Garrett kind of just playing off of Vitality as at this moment. Justin's just been getting the ball hit to him. He's the magnet right now, which I'm sure Energy likes because he's just really good at wasting time with his air dribbles and solo plays. Turbo. I don't know if... let's see if K-Dop could have ripped this. So this is actually a really good pass by Fairy Peak. So Garrett's touch, not the greatest. Now he sees Turbo turning, right? So instead of just... He could have just boomed this forward, but that would have gave Turbo the ball, right? And it would have gave Turbo the time to stall for Garrett and Justin to get back and boost, which a lot of this game is just stalling for your teammates to get in position. But instead he passes it. And because Turbo's backwards, unfortunately K-Dop isn't there. But if K-Dop was there, this is literally a 1v1. And you'll take a 1v1, especially in these games, a lot of the times. But see, like, this is what the grand finals and why Fairy Peak and Vitality were so good is just because under the pressure, they're not just booming the ball downfield and hoping for the best. They're still using their comms, their just game sense, and their just like, you know, overall skill to realize, all right, this part of the field's open. I see my opponents. I'm going to capitalize and hit it in the middle of the field, right? Unfortunately, it's a little bit far, but still, it puts pressure on Energy. Again, K-Dot or Fairy Peak trying to do the same thing. Energy's now waiting. But again, good early challenge before it gets to net by Turbo. Fairy Peak just diming out. Garrett with a misread. Ooh. Fairy, I bet he wish he could have that pass. It looked like he's trying to pass again, which I honestly don't think was a bad play. But I don't think it wasn't a good enough touch. Fairy Peak probably didn't need to go back for boost there. Good demo by Scrub. Fairy with 50. Oh my god. Okay, yeah. So this honestly is all open. So Justin gets the touch, right? But this is all opened up because Scrub Killer gets this demo. If Scrub doesn't get this demo, this whole goal doesn't happen. So it's physical play. K-Dop also going for a demo, which forces Garrett to stay grounded. Because of this, Fairy Peak can 50-50. Goes in front of the net. Justin doesn't get the good enough 50, and Scrub capitalizes. So we're going to go to Turbo. But that was... Vitality realized they needed to make something happen, so physical play was the answer for them. Turbo with a risky pass off kickoff. Probably poorly communicated with his teammates. He thought that one of them was going to be available, but they weren't in reality. Again, probably going to see some boom ball, because it's just basically kill the time. Bad double commit from Vitality. That could have been really bad. But luckily, no one from Energy is there. Justin, solo play. Can he make magic? Oh, Fairy Peak with a good challenge. That would have been scary if you didn't get that. See, if that's one of the ones, you wait till you're like he comes to net, that's when you're not doing too hot. So Justin, again, possession for energy off kickoff, but he does get dunked. Turbo. So now Vitality is the pressure, right? They have had pressure since kickoff. Fairy Peak with a good double touch to draw out one. Okay, this is the problem. So Fairy Peak's kind of going off right now, right? He's beating defenders left, right, and center. So he gets the double touch. Gets past another. But Vitality is in this Game 7 overtime mentality where you don't want to get scored on. So look how far K-Dop is. The K-Dop should not be this far just because if he wants... Like, he should know... Look how slow the ball's going. He knows Scrub's third man, right? Okay, so he's kind of that far because he was just playing for the worst, right? Which is Game 7 overtime nerves. You don't want to let a goal in. So But look how slow the ball is. If you're in K-Dop's position, you do not want to be this far because the ball is not going to get to you when the ball is moving this slow. Maybe if it was slamming off the backboard, but since Fairy Peak's essentially dribbling, he should be a little bit closer. But Turbo gets a good demo, and then I think we all know what happens. Since Justin... Hello? Please. Okay. So Justin gets the boost, gets beat, but it's honestly fine because it forces out the challenge. Garrett, Turbo with the demo. Scrubs last man. Boom. GG's. Just one quick counterattack. One mistake is what caused it. But as we can see, Energy was honestly just the better team. Vitality had their moments and adapted as really well, as well as playing Energy's mistakes. But Energy was just the more dominant team. They were just the ones forcing Vitality kind of back and kind of making Vitality play Energy's game. But yeah, Energy, I think Energy was just the more dominant team in general. But I don't know, this is pretty cool because I the series has been a while and this was actually the last LAN we had. We all miss LANs, don't we? But yeah, if you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to leave a like and subscribe. Comment. What should we comment? Goldstone if you guys reach the end of the video. But I greatly appreciate you guys for watching. Make sure to subscribe if you're new. It's free. Just click the red button. I'd appreciate it. But peace out. Have a good rest of your day.